I want to explain you as clearly as possible what it takes to set up your own Wikibase reconciliation service and how to use that in OpenRefine. And I've given this presentation before within the context of the Dutch Wikibase working group, and I try to improve it and make it even a bit more clear for this particular meeting. And I'm Olaf. I'm Olaf Janssen. I'm the Wikimedia coordinator of the KB, which is the National Library of the Netherlands. And as I just said to Timothy, tomorrow we will celebrate our 225th birthday. So there will be a big party in our library. And I've been working for the library for more than two decades now. And for the last 9 years, I've been involved in Wikimedia collaboration. And I'm the Wikimedia coordinator. So in that role, I try to link up two worlds. On the one hand, there is the world of our library with our collections and knowledge and data and information and people. And on the other hand, there is the world of Wikimedia with Wikipedia, of course, and Wikidata and Commons and increasingly also Wikibase and the communities that surround those platforms. And I try to make those two worlds collaborate with each other to mutual benefit. And I've been doing that for 9 years and I'm really still liking my job. So I hope to, I always say I have the best job in the library. And I hope to continue that that for the foreseeable future. And what I would like to give to you today are actually three things in my presentation. First of all, I hope that after this session, you will have a better understanding what it takes to set up a reconciliation service for your own Wikibase instance. Secondly, how you can use that reconciliation service in the context of OpenRefine. And I hope that my slides are another piece of documentation or reference material that you can use to understand what it takes to set up your own recon service. I try to make my presentations as visual as possible. And I know there's a lot of documentation for this particular topic already. But I have visual slides. I do a lot of screenshots and a lot of images. So I hope that if you don't want to read a lot of text, you can also look at the visual explanation that I will provide via this slide deck. And now, just to build up my story, I will start really simply. I assume this is common knowledge for people working with Wikidata, but just to make sure that we're all starting on the same page, let me just show you an example of working with Wikidata and OpenRefine and explaining you what reconciliation is. And I've made a sample OpenRefine project. And on the screen, you see a list of names, and those are winners of a particular Dutch literary award. And in the second column, you see the names of the years that the awards were won. And reconciliation, that's the process of converting. Yes?
I may, just a note that we're seeing your notes and your as well as the slides, so I'm not sure if that's something that could be changed, where we can just look at the slide and not see the kind of the notes panel.
Oh, the notes on the side, you also see.
Yeah,
that.
Yeah,
if I make this small like this,
I think that's better. Yeah.
Oh yeah, that's more. Yeah, okay, that's more visually attractive. Yeah.
Someone
okay, thanks for pointing that out. I was not aware of that. I'm sorry. And you also see, do you also see the black thing around my slide then?
Yes, we do.
Yeah, so it should be full screen then, I guess. Mm-hmm. Let me try to modify that. I think this is better.
Yes, that looks much better. Thank
yeah,
you.
Yeah, okay, that looks much better. Okay, so it's sorry for this. Let me continue my story. So reconciliation, that's the process of converting these strings, these person names, into things. In this case, queue numbers, queue things, items on Wikidata. And if you use OpenRefine, you know how to do that. You go to the column, then you select reconcile, start reconciling. And then you always get this, on the left side, this menu of the reconciliation service that you want to use. And for Wikidata, there are two reconciliation services shown. The first one is the English one, so you can reconcile against the English language content in Wikidata. And the second one is the Dutch one, so you can reconcile against Dutch. And the next screen you get is a suggestion of types you want to use. And because we're talking about Dutch writers here, those are humans, so we select Q5. And then you start the reconciliation process. You get this nice progress indication. And once that's done, you have this list of mostly reconciled winners, except for the person here, Ruud van Gessel. I guess there must be two Ruud van Gessels in Wikidata. So there's always a little bit of manual work to select the correct Ruud van Gessel. What I want to do next is to look at the reconciliation service behind Wikidata in a bit more detail. And a good place to start is by looking at the reconciliation service test bench. This is a table where all the reconciliation services that are available for OpenRefine are linked. This page is also linked from within OpenRefine. And the first one is Wikidata. And then if you go to the URL here, but you leave out the /en/API, you end up at what I always call the homepage of the reconciliation service of Wikidata. This is basically the end user documentation. And in that page, there are three links that I want to show you. The first one are in the first red box, and the first and second one and the third one is up there. And the first page that I want to show you, but I'm not going to talk about this in detail, is the full specification of the Reconciliation Service API. This is really technical documentation, and if you want to read all the details about how this service works and how you can look up all kinds of errors, then you have to go to this page. I must admit, I've started reading it a while ago, but I didn't finish the full document. It was a bit too advanced and technical for me. A better page to look at if you want to understand how to set up your own reconciliation services is this one. This is the documentation for the administrators and developers. And I will come back to this page a bit later in my talk. And the third thing I would like to show you is the page, the service endpoint. So this is a JSON response. And this is these are the URLs you need to paste into OpenRefine if you want to make use of the reconciliation service. And the language codes that are printed in bold on my slide, you can add those if you want to use certain languages to reconcile against. This is for Wikidata, which I showed you. Now I want to look at reconciliation services of other Wikibase instances. And the first one we can look at is the Wikimedia Commons one. And since structured data became available on Wikimedia Commons, Wikimedia Commons is also a Wikibase instance. And on the left side, you see the homepage of the reconciliation service. And on the right-hand side, you see this service API endpoint. And you see this looks strikingly similar to the Wikidata pages that I showed before. Next, let's look at Artbase of Rhizome. This was the first Wikibase outside of the Wikimedia world. And Rhizome also provides a reconciliation service. And again, the two pages, they look really similar to the ones from Wikidata and from Wikimedia Commons. Another example is the one of the EU Knowledge Graph. This is a European Wikibase instance that has information about 1.8 million projects financed or co-financed by the European Union and over 600,000 beneficiaries of these projects. And this Wikibase instance also has a recon service associated with it. And again, you see these two pages look really similar to the ones I showed before. And just to be even more convincing, let's look at the final Wikibase. And this is the Wikibase of the Municipal Art Museum in my hometown in The Hague. And they also have their own Wikibase instance. And you see, again, these pages look really similar. So you might wonder, they all look the same. What is the common recipe behind all these Wikibase reconciliation instances? What is the hidden secret, so to say, or the hidden recipe? And that's what I'm going to talk now in the second half of my presentation. I want to explain you in three relatively simple steps how you can set up your own reconciliation service for your own Wikibase and how to use that in OpenRefine. But first, let me check so far. Are there any questions or remarks that you would like to ask or add to my story? I guess that's...
Yeah, I don't see anything in the chats, really.
Mm-hmm. Okay, then let me continue with my story. So three steps you can take to set up your own reconciliation service. But actually, there are four steps because there is kind of a hidden step zero. And step zero is about, let me call it boundary conditions that you need to check before you can take the next three steps. And these boundary conditions have to do with the following. The first of all is that you have to check, but most of the times when you set up your own Wikibase instance, this is already in place, is that you have a working Sparkle query service on your Wikibase. And you have to make sure that in your Wikibase, you have created two properties. The first one is an instance of property. And the second one is the subclass of property. In Wikidata, they are P31 and P279, but in your typically in your own Wikibase, they will have other property numbers. But they have to be called like that and have to be, yeah, they have to be present in your Wikibase instance. Next, you have to check that you have two MediaWiki extensions installed in your Wikibase. The first one is the Universal Language Selector. And the second one is the Series Search extension. And you can do that by going to the special column version page of your Wikibase instance. It's a special page, and it's available on every MediaWiki instance. And if you go to that page, you will see a list of all the extensions that are installed. And if one of the required extensions is not there, you can, if you have admin privileges to the Wikibase, you can install it yourself. Otherwise, you have to ask your system administrator or another tech person, let me call it that way, to actually install these extensions for you. And the fourth thing you have to make sure is that you know or you know someone who can work with Docker and Docker Compose. Okay, once you have checked that, you can progress to the first step. And the first step is to set up the reconciliation service itself. And how do you do that? You can do that by going to this repository on GitLab, and here you find all the code that is needed to set up this, the reconciliation service. And as I showed you, the ones from Wikidata and Wikimedia Commons and Rhizome, etc. Those are all based on this particular repository on GitLab. This code used to be hosted on GitHub, but they moved it over to GitLab. That doesn't really matter, but as the code is still the same. But if you want to grab the latest updates from this repo, go to the GitLab, the place on GitLab. The code on GitHub is still working, but that's an archived version of the code. And on GitLab, the newest releases are available. Now you can go to the page that I showed you before, and there you see an explanation of actually how to install that. And the first thing is you go to that page, and there is this header called Installing with Docker. And actually on that page, there is a little error because that page is still referring to the old place of the repository on GitHub. So actually this should be this one. It's the same Git clone command, but now working on GitLab. And once you have downloaded the code, you go into the openrefine-wikibase directory. And in that directory, you will find a file that is called config.py. And the config.py file you need to change, you need to adapt to include the parameters of your own Wikibase instance. And if you wonder what a typical config.py file looks like, this is an example that I created myself a while ago. And this is configured towards a Wikibase instance that we as the National Library run, KB Test Wikibase it's called, and that's a sandbox Wikibase environment that we use to do all kinds of experiments and sandboxy things, and just to get a better understanding of what a Wikibase instance is and how it works. And it's, as you can see from the URL, it's hosted on wikibase.cloud. So this is not an official part of our infrastructure, but still it's a nice playing ground to get a better understanding of how Wikibase works. And basically you can, if you want to, you can grab this file, and all you need to do is to change all the base URLs you see here on the screen with, you have to replace them with your own base URLs of your own Wikibase instance. And what is important is there is, if you scroll down that page, you will come across a variable that is called this host. And by default, it's located at localhost port 8000. And this is the URL that the recon service will run from. So if you have a fully qualified domain name, you can also put it in there, and then the reconciliation service will be available from that particular URL. So you make sure that your config.py file is fully configured towards your own Wikibase instance. And once you have done that, you save it, of course, and then you start the recon service by giving the command docker compose up. And then the reconciliation service, if all went well, becomes available at the URL you specified at this host parameter. And I want to show you how that looks like for the Municipal Art Museum, the Kunstmuseum. Kunst means art in Dutch, in The Hague, because they did this process. And this is the slide I showed you before. They have a working reconciliation service with an endpoint here, which is specified for NL. So this is for the Dutch language. And if you want to use this in OpenRefine, you can use, for instance, this is an example project. These are all painters, basically. Of course, Vincent van Gogh, I think that's the most well-known international painter. And we want to find these artists within the Wikibase instance of the Kunstmuseum. And now you can add that reconciliation service endpoint URL to OpenRefine. You do that by add standard service. You paste in the URL in the dialog screen you get, you save it, and then service endpoint or the reconciliation service is available from OpenRefine. And now you can use that service to reconcile the person, so to convert them from names into entities within the Kunstmuseum Wikibase. And just to check that the process will go quite smoothly in this case, and just to check that Vincent van Gogh is indeed in the Kunstmuseum Wikibase, it's number Q8 within that Wikibase. So just to wrap up, what is the result of this first step is that if you make sure that the service is publicly available, it's not behind a firewall or something like that, is that anyone can now reconcile data against your Wikibase. Okay, that's step one. Let's continue with step two. And step two is about connecting OpenRefine to your Wikibase instance. And it means that you make sure that OpenRefine can discover your Wikibase instance and also can write to your Wikibase instance. And the way to do that is to create a so-called manifest. And a manifest that is a file formatted in the JSON format that you need to add to OpenRefine to allow it to discover and write data to a target Wikibase. And you might wonder, well, how do I start if I want to make such a file? I would not advise you immediately to start it from scratch, but rather take an existing manifest JSON file and modify that for your own needs. And a good place to look for example manifests is this repository of OpenRefine called Wikibase-manifests. And you can, for instance, grab the manifest from Rhizome, from Artbase. And if you open that, you see a really quite simple JSON file, actually. And all you need to do to adapt it for your own Wikibase is basically change the name and basically change all these base URLs that are given here from our basement Rhizome to your own URLs. The thing to point out here, which is important, is that if you want to do that, you already need to have a reconciliation service in place. So first make sure you have the recon service, then you build the manifest JSON. Otherwise it won't work. This is a really simple example. If you want to read all about all the parameters and all the things you can do to make more elaborate manifests, then you can go to this page and here all the parameters and all the variables that you can use in a manifest are explained. And you also get some examples of more complex manifests, like this one is from Wikidata. And as you can see from only the top of this JSON file, it looks more complicated. And I have to point out, so this a manifest file you have to publish as a Wikibase owner or a Wikibase publisher. You have to publish it yourself so that people that want to use OpenRefine and that want to write to your Wikibase can use that manifest JSON in OpenRefine. It's not something that end users will make themselves, but you have to provide it as a Wikibase publisher. And let's look again at the Kunstmuseum in The Hague. They made such a manifest. They have published that on their Wikibase instance. And as you can see from this JSON structure, it's pretty much always the same base URL. Apparently they also have this instance of and subclass of, and within their Wikibase it's P4 and P47. You have to make sure that you configure this for your own Wikibase. And they also have their reconciliation endpoint here, as I pointed out before. What you do now, you copy paste, you copy this JSON structure, and then you go to OpenRefine and assume you have a project and you have some edited data that you would like to upload to the Kunstmuseum Wikibase instance at some point. First, you must make sure that OpenRefine can find that Wikibase instance, and you go to Manage Wikibase Instances. And by default, you will have Wikidata in it. And I, in this case, already added Wikimedia Commons. But now I would like to add the Kunstmuseum Wikibase instance. And you do that by going to Add Wikibase. Then you paste in this big box, you paste in that JSON response directly. And what you could also do here in the smaller bar above, you could also paste in a URL to that JSON file. And if you do that, make sure that you point towards the raw, unformatted version of the JSON and not like the HTML rendered version that you often see in your browser. Really make sure that it's really the root, the raw JSON response. I always try to do it in a manifest way, so I just grab the response itself and paste it in the big box and not in the URL here, so that I make sure that I know I can check everything is okay and I know what I'm doing. And once I've checked that, you say add Wikibase, and then the Wikibase instance will appear in that menu and it will become active automatically. And now you can start writing to the Kunstmuseum Wikibase instance. And how do you do that? Say you have made some edited data that you want to upload. You go to OpenRefine, you do upload edits to Wikibase. And then you will get a login screen from the Wikibase, because if you want to write, you typically need an account on the Wikibase, which has write permission. I didn't take the trouble to register myself on the Wikibase or the Kunstmuseum Wikibase. So this is a step you would need to do. Equivalently, I think most Wikibase instances will actually be, you have to make an account, I assume. And once your account is approved by the owners of the Wikibase, you should be able to write edits to the Wikibase from OpenRefine. So as a summary, the result of step two is that approved contributors can now upload edits from OpenRefine to your Wikibase. When I first started doing this myself, I thought that step zero, step one, and step two were enough. That didn't turn out to be true, because there is a third step you need to make sure that you take. And this step, I found out, it's a bit less well documented in all the documentation that I went through. So it took me some time to figure this out myself. And I want to stress, this is important that you also check that you do this if you want to have everything working without errors. And the first one has to do with adding tags. And what it is, I can explain best by, again, going to the manifest JSON file of the Kunstmuseum in The Hague. And there you see this particular line. The key is called tag. And then you see OpenRefine-$ and then version. And what you can think of, how does it look like if you render this? It's something like this. It's OpenRefine-3.5, 3.6, or 3.7. And now when you want to make sure that people using one of those versions of OpenRefine can write to your Wikibase, what you need to configure in your Wikibase are tags on a page that is called special:tags. This is also a page that is available in all MediaWiki instances. And you have to make sure that you add one per row these tags to this page. This is something you can't do as a normal user, so you have to ask your sysadmin, or if you have admin privileges yourself, you can do it yourself. But typically you have to ask the sysadmin to do that. To add these two lines, OpenRefine 3.6, in these two cells. And the important thing is to make sure that the format of this string is exactly openrefine dash 3.6, as it is the same as it is here. I made the error myself. I tried to change this actually without changing it here, and then it didn't work. So make sure that the format is exactly the same. And if you, for instance, if you want to allow people that use OpenRefine 3.5 also to write to your Wikibase, then create an extra row with also OpenRefine 3.5 in it. If you don't do that, you will typically get errors in your OpenRefine console, let me call it that way. And the errors will look something like this. You get error while editing, and then la la la, and then you will get these tag names. And this is because for this screenshot, I did not actively add these tags to the special tags page on the Wikibase instance I was using. And then finally, and this I found out also the hard way, is that you have to set your page protection level on your Wikibase in the correct way. And this has to do with that most people that will typically work on a Wikibase will do this as an auto-confirmed user. And to allow these auto-confirmed users to write to your Wikibase, you must make sure that the page protection level of your Wikibase is set to allow only auto-confirmed users. How do I demonstrate this? This is a screenshot from Wikidata, but the same logic will apply to your own Wikibase instance. And by going to this URL and change this according to your own Wikibase instance, you will get an overview of all semi-protected pages. And for those pages, make sure that the page protection level is set to allow edits by only auto-confirmed users. And you can do that by going to this URL and in an admin mode, I must say you must be admin to do this, and then change this level accordingly. And you can also make a setting in your Wikibase that newly created pages, newly created queue numbers, so to say, automatically have this setting in the correct way. And just to be consistent with my other two results for all the steps, the result of this third step is that OpenRefine and Wikibase don't throw any errors while trying to upload data to the Wikibase. Okay, that was my story. If you want to read it just in simple text, let me put it that way. If you go to the KBNL account on GitHub and go to this repo here, OpenRefine-Wikibase, there is a page that explains the most of the things I just talked about. So you can go there and you can check it out yourself. Of course, if you have any questions, feel free to contact me, and I think I might be able to help you in getting your own recon service running. Okay, that was it for me. Thank you very much.